Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm hoping you guys are all having a fantastic day, because guess what? I sure am having an absolutely fabulous day. Reason for that is, I finally decided to make my ENCO outlook for summer and fall. So, you know, ENSO. And ENSO is usually associated with the winter and El Niño or La Niña, but it still has impacts on the summer. Now, I will not be going into this video on the impacts it will have for summer. It will just be an ENC or ENSO outlook for the summer and the fall. So this is nothing to do with winter or even the impacts it has. It's just what's going to happen. Is it going to be an El Niño? Is it going to be a La Niña? Is it gonna be perhaps a neutral? We'll answer this all in this video. So, I will be making another video though soon, and it will be on what are the impacts of it possible, you know, for summer and fall. And, I'm just excited because all I'm saying is the season is starting yet again. And I know it seems like it's May, but, you know, the very first skirmishes, if you will, are beginning to form. The skirmishes of the new season. I really don't know how to describe it, but just kind of like, you know, onset of the season. So if you like to support this channel through fall and winter, and if you like this content that I make, try to upload as often as I can, and not always as consistent as I would like. You could subscribe. It's a red subscribe button. You could just hit it and be subscribed. That is a huge favor for me. That's all you have to do, and like the video and leave a nice comment if you're willing to do so. So the main idea is El Niño is present right now. There's an El Niño right now. I'm sorry, I'm just looking for my cat because he just disappeared somewhere. All right, the El Niño is, that was kind of random, but the El Niño is present right now, which, again, I won't be going over what it means for the summer, upcoming summer or fall, but I will be doing that in a separate video, but I'm just here to discuss what's going on. So an El Niño is present, and that basically, if you don't know, I got a comment recently asking about, to tell you guys more about the information, where I get it from, and to educate you guys more on this stuff, so that they could learn more. And I didn't reply to it, but don't worry, I've heard of you, you know who you are. I read that comment and took it personally, and no, it definitely wasn't negative. I liked it. I agree with that. So thank you for proposing that. I don't always respond to comments, but I read 100% of them, guys. I seriously do. So just because I don't respond doesn't mean I didn't read it. And you can see that the El Niño is basically a area of warmer temperatures or cooler temperatures, as you see marked by this map here. Here, if you could see, is Papua New Guinea. Here is Australia. Right there is South America. Here is Central America, and up north is North America. And we have these waters right here. So this is the Pacific Ocean extending from South America to the East Pacific, into West Pacific into the Southeast Asia area. And you can see it's basically it's divided into these regions, and each region plays a role. And you can see in the past in the past couple of weeks, the latest weekly SST, so sea surface temperature departures, they're going all positive. They're growing in terms of anomalies. You can see it's getting warmer, so a stronger El Niño is developing, but you could see a weak El Niño is still in present and will likely to continue through Northern Hemisphere summer, 65% chance, and possibly fall. That is completely up to the game. I want to emphasize that so much, guys. This, just because right now, here's a better look at it. Here's where the El Niño, hopefully you can see where my mouse is. Here is where the El Niño region is, the ENSO region is. And that's where they always look for whether it's cooler, a La Niña, it's, you know, within the 0.5 degrees, a neutral, or if it's an El Niño. And El Niño is marked by warmer conditions, and it is warmer. And if you recall, last year, it was fall, and we kept anticipating an El Niño to form, but it did not form till late January and into February, and it was much delayed, as it was supposed to form into October, and even parts of September were supposed to be an El Niño. So, again, even close out, the ENSO predictions are very, you gotta take them with not too much greatness, as they could change drastically. So you can see this is a great website. I know that people again ask me to show you. Just type in ENSO, those letters, ENSO Outlook, and the first one you'll see literally is this, and it's like a PowerPoint presentation, and it has so many cool things you could read about this. And it takes, you know, a little bit to know about this, but you don't have to be a genius in order to read this. You don't have to even know too much about meteorology to differentiate, okay, so this logically leads to this and that, and, you know, make a kind of like a, you know, from point to point lead to a conclusion. If you're like me explaining this more, then leave a comment that you like this. So you see, this is what it basically looked like, the 17th of April, that anomaly. So basically the temperature changed from average, and you can see it's been generally above average for this area, maybe a little bit declining though in warmth, but definitely not below average on this area right here across that x-axis, that is warm temperatures or warm sea surface temperatures. There's a lot here. I mean, if I wanted to go over this whole thing, this would be a 20-30 minute video, and I know that you would, maybe possibly some people would like this, a 20-30 minute video. I'm just telling you that would be a nightmare to upload, and that would also be a not many people would watch a 20-30 minute video. So I try making this closer. There's so much stuff you could look through. I just want to go through the most important stuff. You can see interseasonal variability, Matt and Julian oscillation, the MJO. There's so many things to explain, guys. And I love every part of this, but again, I can't all fit this in one video, as I'm already at 7 minutes almost with this recording, and I want to go through the best I can and most important stuff. So you can see that right here, this is basically the outline for the basics. If you don't know what an El Niño is, it is characterized by a positive ONI greater than or equal to 0.5. degrees above average. So if it's negative 0.5 to positive 0.5, that is characterized as a neutral. Anything below is a La Niña, anything above is an El Niño. And of course, there are phases. There's a thing called a strong La Niña and a weak La Niña. Weak El Niño and a strong El Niño. That may not seem relevant. Oh boy, I'm telling you, that is so important. So important. That could change a whole outcome of a winter, summer, fall. Any of those seasons could be changed by whether it's a strong or weak one. I want to emphasize that that a El Niño or a La Niña has a greater impact on the winter time weather. It does not have as great of an impact on the summer weather in terms of the pattern across in North America. But on the winter, it has a great pattern. It's still impactful for the summer, but not to as great of extent as El Niño in the winter versus a La Niña in the winter. Those things could mean a completely different outcome. La Niña versus El Niño during the summer, yeah, they have their differences, just not as immense of an impact. So this is a whole historical El Niño and La Niña episodes based on the ONI computed using a specific model, and you can see it goes from 2007 to the 2019 year. So that is 12 years of record keeping, and you can see some years are neutral, some months are neutral, some months are positive or negative. So La Niña, some are positive and El Niño. Right now we are the past months were in El Niño, and you can see it only developed. They're showing it here developed in September, October, November, December time frame. It did not. I'm telling you guys, it was a very obscure pattern. It did not really develop until December and January, like I mentioned previously. It was a very weak and not really noticeable change across these September, October, November time frame. And as you could see, I already mentioned this probably, I think I did, that the El Niño conditions are gonna occur through most of the fall and winter right now. But again, I want to put a strong emphasis on this. This is so bound to change. It is absolutely ridiculous how much this could change. I remember, and I'll always remember this experience because it is worth sharing and it's worth remembering. So I was doing a winter outlook, and I think this was 2017, so I was still very new to this stuff. Not new, completely new. I've been doing this for several years before it, but I didn't know that the ENCO or ENSO outlook could change so drastically. And I literally recorded a video July 24th, if I recall correctly. It's forecasted an El Niño for throughout the whole fall and winter of that specific year. And guess what happened a week later? It changed completely into a La Niña pattern. It could change that drastically, guys. So take this with, honestly, a grain of salt. I know that seems a little bit aggressive, but especially take it with a grain of salt for late fall and into winter, that is bound to change. And it's most likely... Okay, guys, so I'm sorry the video paused there because I went over 10 minutes. But what, as I was saying, that's more likely to be a different outcome from than an El Nino itself. So, summer most likely will be an El Nino since it's in a fairly confident right now, almost 90%. But I would say anything after September, even August, is a huge gamble. So, you could see that these are the models now that they use to predict an El Nino or an La Nina or the ENSO outlook prediction. And you could see that the majority of them are not too drastically changing, or they are between 0.5 and 1. So, a weak El Nino, and this goes out into December, January, February of 2020. And again, this is still bound to change, and you could see how widespread these models get. I mean, one is showing a very strong El Nino to a not necessarily a La Nina, but a neutral pattern. So a lot of things could change, and I just wanted to give you a quick little outlook on what's to come. And again, I will be making a video soon on what are the impacts of an El Nino during the summer and fall. This was just what's going to happen during summer and fall. What's the El Nino, what the ENSO is going to do. So thank you guys so much for watching. Consider subscribing. Consider liking to the video. And I'll catch you all guys on the next episode. See ya. Bye.